What do you think, though, is happening right now? Like, how are people dealing? What do you think is going on with interracial couples? Like, do you think there's specific things that are coming up? I know that you're doing well in your relationship, which I love to hear that. But what do you think, what do you think is going on with couples right now? What do you think they're navigating?
Yes. From a coaching perspective, I know, and again, I can put my professional dating empowerment hat on. I've been a coach for 12 years in the dating relationship space and consent space as well. And from a professional and a personal perspective, there are couples that are very much struggling right now. I've had a few conversations with friends in my life who are dating, who have a Black partner. So either, you know, the guy is Black, the girl is Black, both people, whatever, regardless of orientation. And it's a hard time if the couple hasn't had these conversations before. And, you know, again, like literally 2019, right? Things were light and airy compared to now. Light and fun and festivals and right. Vegas and like all these things, right? It's like another yes. lifetime.
It really was.
Right. And so, you know, in a lot of ways, why would you need to have had those conversations? Someone approaches you on a dating app or in a bar or something, like, again, pre-COVID. And it's like, oh my God, you're cute. I'm cute. Yes, let's go out. And so, you know, again, like I mentioned before, there's been a lot of stuff that's come up for me in the last week that I haven't really thought about since I was like in school, you know? Really? And so a lot of Black people are dealing with that. There's some deep, deep trauma that is popping up for us right now. And so if you're in a couple, for the couples who are out there, you know, who've maybe never discussed things, race things, or race things to this depth, this is a big eye opener. I mean, right. I've been in relationships before. This is the moment for some couples where they might have to call it quits. There might be a fundamental thing that pops up in this that Black person might not feel safe anymore. You know, yeah. If somebody says, say there's a Black and white couple and the Black person says, you know, like I said before, like, I don't feel safe out there. And the white person says, oh, it's not a big deal. Like, just come, nothing's going to happen to you. Like, that is traumatic. To feel yeah. like you're not being seen or heard or believed, that your feelings are like not real or like invalid. That's happening right now. Really quickly, is there's a lot of conversation about interracial children. I have a few friends who have biracial children, and in both situations, the mother is white and the father is Black. And in one situation in particular, the white mom said something like, I'm going to shield my kids from what's happening. My biracial kids who are part Black, because I think I'm just going to teach them to be a good person. Right. They don't need to be fearful like you are. And I said, oh my God, listen to, please, please, please. Yeah. If you don't listen to anything else, please listen to me. That's not going to help. Like, yes, it's important. Yes. Yes. Be positive in all these things, but they need to know what's happening out there and they need to know, but they need to be careful. And I'm like, yeah. Start, all of a sudden getting emotional. Cause I'm like, that is so hurtful to hear. That a mother is so like not wanting to be a negative person, that they're not wanting to tell their kid about what's happening. It's not okay. And that is super dangerous.
Yeah, I totally agree with you, Erin. You're so right. We have to have difficult conversations with our kids, no matter what color their skin, but especially in this case. I mean, you're so right. I think we're so afraid. We want to make this perfect world of, like, you know, rainbows and sunshine. And that's just not the reality. If not now, when?